looks like we are going to see another Orbital Command really going to just pop out a ton of mules here. Obviously, if he takes this expansion, he might think about a Planetary Fortress, but usually Planetary Fortresses are for your third and fourth Expos, the Expos that you can't expand, or the Expos you can't defend, excuse me, very, very easily. But Twilight Council is up. What's he going to choose to get out of here? Probably Zealot Legs or probably Storm Tech nonetheless. Storm is really getting popular here. For the first bit of StarCraft 2, it was all Colossi Tech, but that's quickly changing. A lot of pylons warping in, and that's exactly me right here. I should take a screenshot. That's what happens with me when I'm playing. I get like supply cap. Screw it, 6 pylons, you know, then use the shift and it's like PPPPP. So you just have like one pro building 6 pylons, and then you don't hit a supply block for quite a while. But you also waste a lot of minerals. But nonetheless, looks like Straylock is going to continue pushing here. Nice force field thus far. Can he finish it? He does finish it. And now Straylock's army is way out of position. A few of these Marauders aren't even targeting, and you can just see mana. He has to use these force fields. There's still a lot of units. He really needs to land these force fields, and he does indeed. And I think he might just have enough to clean this up, and it looks like he will, but that is still a lot of medevacs here. Few units, a lot of Marauders not even attacking here. And now you're going to have to see Terran get pushed all the way back into his main base, but he can climb up right back up here, and he's actually taking an expansion. Could this be under pressure if you are Straylock? But nonetheless, it looks like we have Charge going up, and we are going to actually see that Templar Archives. Very, very nice play here. He's going to be able to get that Storm Tech, and Storm Tech is just so super devastating to the Terran ball. But, you know, really, medevac count needs to be high, and you really have to try to micro away from those storms as best as possible. But I think Storm is really outproving Colossi Tech at this point. But looks like he's going to push in here. It looks like Mana's going to push in here. And alongside, though, we have a couple. Ooh, I thought that was a medevac. Those are just Vikings. He's going to be able to get a tiny bit of harassment off until more units can be warped in. But doesn't look like that's where I should be looking right now, as he is going for this third expansion. I don't think he's going to be able to defend it. Looks like that command center or that orbital command has lost all of its SCVs thus far. More units desperately coming alongside Straylock, and it looks like he might just have enough to hold them off, but he did lose a few SCVs. Let's go ahead and take a look at the income tab. You can still see so similar, though, because Mana hasn't quite taken that third expo. I feel it's a bit of a mistake. How many probes did he lose to these Vikings? I think he probably transferred them, but you'd expect him to warp them in and take care of these. If he takes out the gas, obviously, this is crucial gas mining time, which is really going to limit the Templar tech here for a moment. Looks like Storm is about a fourth of the way through. These Vikings are going to reroute themselves all the way back home, and this orbital command is back up. I was surprised. I might have thought of Planetary Fortress with that early of a third expo.